Yo, what's going on, guys? It is Foxy290 here. Welcome back to a brand new video for you guys today here on the channel. Today we're here for my F1 2019 career mode here for the Chinese Grand Prix. And as you can see, first things first, we've got a couple of developments that have actually gone onto the car, and we have had a couple that have failed, which is kind of frustrating. But anyway, let's have a look and see what failed. Annoyingly, my major upgrades failed, and then my minor upgrades worked. So it's a bit of a shame there. So we had a major chassis upgrade that we were looking to put onto the car, and we also had a major front downforce upgrade that we were trying to put onto the car, and unfortunately none of them actually arrived. So we just have the two minor drag upgrades going onto the car. But you can see there, look, in terms of the performance comparison chart, where we're at in just in every department, and really we're just getting out developed right now. You can see the upgrades there in terms of where people are at, and people are just upgrading really quick. And unfortunately, even though we're, you know, pumping in the upgrades, they're not coming fast enough. So yeah, that's kind of where we stand in terms of things. But if we have a look then into qualifying, first of all here, we're now coming around towards the final corner here, and I struggled in qualifying. I really did struggle. We come across the line here, and it's 0.4 seconds behind Sergio Perez. Bottas then just makes me go 1.3 seconds slower. And I decided to try and stay, try and risk it and stay with the one run for Q1. Yeah, it didn't work. We were just under 0.1 seconds knocked out in Q1. I tried it on one run and it didn't pay off. I should have gone out for a second run, confirm myself for Q2, but I didn't, which is a bit of a cock up there, but it's fine. We're out in Q1. For the race, it's set to be wet. Now, once again, guys, I'm going to keep reiterating it. For my career mode, you will not notice the patch take place until the Canadian Grand Prix. So this is why I have confidence going into the wet, because the AIs will still be rubbish. And like I said, it's Canada where it all changes. But let's get into the race and let's see where we can go for this Chinese Grand Prix.
It's time to find out which driver is up to the task of claiming the Chinese Grand Prix. We're here in Shanghai. The ever-tightening turns 1 and 2 will prove tricky in the slippery conditions here at Shanghai, and anyone that slides wide will lose a lot of time getting back on track. Turn 14 should still be the best place for overtaking, but we'll have to see some improvement in the weather before the drivers can take advantage of that DRS assistance. Anthony Davidson is here once again for today's Grand Prix. Let's talk about Thomas. No grip penalties, no mitigating circumstances, just a poor qualifying performance and a very disappointing start position for them today.
It's not a nice feeling, I promise you. They've got a quick car underneath them, but they've got onto the grid today and they need a pair of binoculars to see the start lights. They'll be desperate for a good start to make up for some of that deficit.
Off the back of a fantastic qualifying session, it's time to see how our starting grid looks for today's race. An immense lap from Lewis Hamilton yesterday puts him on pole position, with Charles Leclerc alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Bottas, Vettel, Max Verstappen, and Sainz, Perez, Gasly, Magnussen, and Roman Grosjean. Butler, Stroll, Lucas Faber, and Norris, Hülkenberg, Thomas, Kimi Raikkonen, and Alexander Albon, Russell, and Antonio Giovinazzi starts from the back of the grid. Now it's almost time to lights out, so let's go down to the track.
Okay, so we are here now for the start of the Chinese Grand Prix. We're going to be starting on the intermediate tyres. It is going to dry up later on in the race, so we are going to go to the dries later. So we really need to take advantage whilst we're on these intermediate tyres. And we've got up to 5 red lights now here for the start of round number 3. And it's lights out. We go here to start the Chinese Grand Prix. Decent, a little bit of a poor actually getaway from us. I thought it was decent, but I can just see that Toro Rosso right on the back of me there as we get under pressure now from one of the other Toro Rossos. We're going to try and go down the inside a little bit here. Lando Norris just sort of cutting my space off a little bit now as we dive it towards the inside here on as many cars as we possibly can, stealing that inside line. It's going to put us on the outside for turn 2. That's not too bad, especially in these intermediate conditions where we've got the traction on the cars as we go past the Haas car there of, I believe it is Grosjean, but the old Grosjean and Magnussen keep swapping in terms of number 1 and number 2 driver. And we have a little look here towards the inside line now and just gently but get ourselves through there. And it's Kevin Magnussen that we're fighting now in the Haas car. And Hamilton leads the way ahead of Charles Leclerc, Bottas, Vettel, Verstappen, and then we've got the two Renaults, and then me, all of a sudden. I've already shot up the grid, and we're very, very high up now as we try and have a look on the back of Carlos in the Renault car. But we've got Gasly trying to come back at me now in the Red Bull. So Pierre got a better run through that middle sector than I did, but we are eligible to hold that off. But I believe that puts us up into P7 or P8 now in this Grand Prix. I could probably do it. It's P8, I think, at the moment. So it's a cracking start for us. I had a look there on Carlos, but there was just no room going in towards this banking corner now. And this is where traction is really, really difficult. The car just constantly loves to slide on you as you try and get on the power. You're desperate to put your foot to the floor, but obviously in these conditions, it just doesn't want to let you. And now it's a long, long drag down the straight here. And this is where the Renault cars have got a lot more straight line speed. The Red Bull is actually the only car, which is Verstappen there in front, who's not got as much straight line speed. You see Gasly there under pressure from one of the Haas cars. We go down the inside now of Carlos there in the Renault car. And that's us up into seventh place now with Sergio Perez next up the road. You can already see how badly Sainz was compromised there. We get a great run actually on Sergio, but it's not going to be enough. But that concludes a cracking first lap here. And already up into seventh place. That's 9 places gained, but it's the intermediate condition. It's wet conditions, pre-patch, so what do you expect? But we're now going to try and press onwards and basically take advantage whilst it's wet. That is the aim for me. I don't know how long the rain's going to stay out for. Sometimes it can stay out longer. Sometimes it will be less. And I just need to basically get as high up the grid as possible. Because obviously, as we see in the dry, I'm not as competitive. But as you can see here, we get a great exit. Oh, Sergio Perez, I think I might have actually whacked into the back of him there slightly. But we now go towards the hairpin here, braking very gently now into here. I actually locked up a little bit on the brakes there. Went a little bit too deep into the corner. But we still get the traction on Sergio, so it's fine. And we're still running hot lap at the moment, ERS-wise. Now we're chasing onto Verstappen. And one lap later, we're now onto the back of Max himself, actually. And you can see now as we go through, we're just taking our gentle time here through here now. And Verstappen is trying to see if he can defend the position. But eventually, out of here, this is where we get the best traction. Now, the exit of turn two, you can see here, already flying through an arm, Max. We're going to go to the outside line here for our run in towards turn four. And we're just going to break down the around the outside, on Max here. This time around, we didn't go deep on the brakes, but that means going around the outside, we can improve on traction. And yeah, I know this is pre-patch. Like, I haven't actually done a career mode race yet in the wet post-patch. Yeah, as you can see now, we're going to go down the outside of Vettel, but we don't actually get the run that I was looking for there on Sebastian. But if the AI, I haven't done much testing with the AIs in the wet post-patch, but if they're still as bad as they are now, which is, you can see them flying through there, always try and make your moves around the outside because you just get the better traction just don't get greedy on the throttle. Lap 5 of the Grand Prix now. We're now onto the back of the Bottas-Leclerc fight here with Lewis Hamilton just started to pull away up front now in the Mercedes. And as you can see, Bottas and Charles look like they're trying to get into a bit of combat here. But for us now, we need to try and make some moves. So as you can see now, we get a very, just such an easy run on Valtteri there through towards turn 2. He's got a straight line speed though, so he'll come back at us and down the inside in towards turn 4. But we'll go around the outside on Bottas here, hold it around there. And you can see we just get on the power and job done. That is us now up into third place in this Grand Prix. Podium positions are ours. And obviously, I need to just keep on pressing. Like I said, I've got time to gain, so let's keep cracking onwards onto lap 6 of the Grand Prix now. Next up is Charles Leclerc, and you can see how the trend is just sort of forming here. We're just getting them in the place that we want them, and obviously you can see here, Charles now is just having a little sneak around, for us, I know exactly where I want to go for my attack, and you can see in the exit, I take an inside line on the exit here, and this time around here, on Charles, just tucking into the slipstream and moving towards the inside line here. Brake a little bit earlier, just so I can get a better run. I can just roll the car through and we set the fastest first sector. We've got the fastest lap as well at the moment, but it'll dry up soon, so we won't get there. But that's us done up to second place now, lap 6 of the Grand Prix, and Charles there can continue to fight onwards. Start of lap 9 now, taking us a couple of laps to get onto the back of Hamilton, but we finally have gotten to the back of him here. And you can see now it's going through, and Hamilton taking a very interesting line in towards turn 1. But as I caught up to Hamilton, the rain has now stopped falling. So it does mean it's going to dry up a lot sooner than what I expected. So that means I do need to try and make some moves here. As Hamilton now gives me a go very tight there on the inside to get through Lewis Hamilton. I wasn't sure where he was defending initially, but we go down the inside. on Hamilton, and we take the lead to the Chinese Grand Prix after some great overtaking from ourselves. And now you can see Bottas and Leclerc there in the background starting to have a bit of a scrap between each other now. Lap 13 of the Grand Prix, and we're going to come in for our first stop of the Grand Prix. It is now time to get off these tyres and to get onto the dry tyres. So we've pretty much done half the race now on these tyres, and then we're going to do half the race on dry tyres. So that's the plan. We're going to come in and we go a little bit wide there. Luckily, there's no gravel, unlike previous years, 2007. Haha, screw you, Lewis. Coming into the pits now for our one and only stop. We're going to go on to the medium tyres, and we're just going to just take those to the end. The mediums can do 14, 15 laps, so we shouldn't have a problem on that front. So in we come now. Brand new set of mediums go on. Hamilton, meanwhile, though, goes on to soft tyres, crucially enough. So he's doing a different strategy to myself. So Lewis is going to be absolutely rapid in this stage of the Grand Prix. Bottas is going to get held a little bit in the pits because, of course, they've just served Hamilton's car. Luckily for me, Sainz has just gone in front of Hamilton. So hopefully, Hamilton can't fully get past Sainz straight away. It just gives me a little bit of extra, like a lap or two in front. It won't be anything else. Norris pits now. Bottas there, you can see, rejoins in third. Bottas a long way off, actually, in third place there. So if Hamilton passes us and can win this race, our fight is going to be with Valtteri Bottas. And on to lap 16 of the Grand Prix. Speaking of the fight with Lewis Hamilton, here he is. He's right on the back of me now. And Bottas, you can see there, still 14 seconds off. But for us, though, I'm going to try and defend against Hamilton here. But obviously, I'm not going to put too much into there. Hamilton gives me a little bit of a barge there, but I did sort of make his line quite tight. And as we go towards the hairpin, that's what I wanted to do. Hamilton locks up on the front left there. Tried to see if I could get a switch line in there, but it was to no avail. I wanted to try and hold up Hamilton for a little bit. I saw the gap to myself and Bottas, and that's what I was sort of referencing myself to. Lap 21 of the Grand Prix, and Hamilton now is pressing onwards here, and he comes into the pits now for a second stop of the race. So he's done a good job, actually, of keeping tabs with Lewis Hamilton, and we regain the lead of this Chinese Grand Prix. Now all we need to do is just get to the start-finish line in front of everybody else. That's just what we got to do. And we just got to keep pressing here. I believe I'm going to show the gap to Bottas. No, I'm not. But as you can see now, it was kind of quiet after that. The last lap of the Grand Prix now, you can see that there's Bottas on the minimap there. So he's closed about 12 out of that 14 seconds on myself. So fair play. The Mercedes were much, much faster today. But obviously, we took advantage in the piece where we were strong, which was the wet. We come round towards the hairpin now. Bottas doing everything he can to close that gap. Vettel in third, Hamilton in fourth. But we're going to come towards the start finish line now. A final corner done and dusted. And we're going to take our first win of Season 2. It is P1 at the Chinese Grand Prix. And thank you very much to the rain gods for blessing me here today. Because if it wasn't raining, I think we probably would have finished a lot further down. But there you can see then is the result of that. We take the top step of the podium, beating the Mercedes and the Ferraris. And that's what we want to be doing this season. We want to try and get as many wins as we possibly can. And this is just a great start to the season. Of course, the car is not competitive enough yet. So I don't expect to get any of these extra anytime soon. But we've got to just see what we got to do. But I'm really, really happy with that race result. And obviously, I just want to show something now. So obviously, having a look at the fastest lap, you can see my fastest lap was 136.4. Just look at the rest of the AIs. 135.4, 135.0, 134.2, 135.9, 36.1, 35.9, 34.4, 37.0, 36.8. Compare that to my lap time, which was a 36.4. Even the Renaults were quicker than me. The Red Bulls were quicker than me. The Haases weren't quite there. So if people, as you can see, the championships, only 5 points actually between myself and Bottas now. We're right in the hunt at the start of the year. So yeah, granted, I was so fast in the wet, the AIs were terrible. And like I said, this is pre-patch. But if you just take into consideration where our race pace was in the dry.
Good day today. Let's have your take on it. Was there really any competition for you today?
I mean, there was. In the dry, you saw it. We were slower than the Renaults.
You were cutting your way through the field during the race.
I was. I didn't really see the engine.
What do you think made the difference between this weekend and last weekend?
It was wet. I like it wet.
You're surpassing all expectations. Can anything or anyone stop you?
A stop sign can, because I literally have to stop them.
Great. Well, that's everything.
Yeah, so like I was saying, in the dry, race pace-wise, we were obviously way slower than Mercedes and Ferrari. And I didn't, in terms of fastest lap, I was not quicker than the Red Bulls, and I wasn't quicker than the Renaults. So it was all it was the rain that gave me what I got today. So anyway, guys, that's going to wrap it up for this episode of My Career Modes here. If you guys have enjoyed it, feel free, like I said, to drop it a like and subscribe to the channel if you have not yet subscribed already. Obviously, next episode is going to be Baku. Last time around, I basically just quit the race because it was so frustrating and terrible. So hopefully we can have some more luck there, but it's probably my weakest track on the calendar in terms of performance versus the AI. So we'll see what we do when we get there. I am going to go ahead and read the transcripts. And I do believe, I don't know if I've already done it yet, but I did go ahead and sort out the upgrades for the pieces that failed, so the major upgrades. I'm just sort of reading the interview transcript there that Devin Bulsack went ahead and progressed through there. So having a look at the R&D tree now. So I've already put the upgrades on for the aero. Now I'm going to do it for the chassis. So we should see both of those now come for Azerbaijan. And we should have a much better car for that race with hopefully a massive aero package coming for that weekend. But anyway, guys, thank you very much for watching. And I will see you guys for the next one. So take care all. Peace.